So Genesis chapter 12, verse 1. Let's read. Verse 1. Now the Lord had said unto Abram, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto a land that I will show thee. And I will make of thee a great nation, and I will bless thee and make my name great. And thou shalt be a blessing, and I will bless them that bless thee, and I will curse him that curseth thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be blessed. Verse 4 says, so Abram departed as the Lord had spoken unto him, and Lot went with him, and Abram was 75 years old when he departed out of Haran. And Abram took Sarai, his wife, Lot, his brother's son, and all their substance that they had gathered and the souls that they had gotten in Haran, and they went forth to go into the land of Canaan, and into the land of Canaan they came. Amen. Well, I'm going to use the subject tonight, three words: courage, faith, and determination. Say it with me. Courage, faith, and determination. One more time. Courage, faith, and determination. That's what we need. We need courage. We need faith, and we need determination. So we read here in Genesis where God told Abraham to leave his country and leave everything that he owned, leave it, because he's going to show him a land where he was going to want him to be. And it took some courage, and it took some faith, some confidence, and he needed some what? Determination. So that's what we need. So God told him to leave. So Abraham got his family and everything he owned and all his substance, all his stuff. He took it all with him. But see, we need courage, we need faith, and we need determination. We need that. Because God told Joshua, in Joshua chapter 1, around verse 5, I think it is, he said, verse 6, he said, told Joshua to be strong, to be strong, to be courageous. See, God knew that you are courageous, and that you are strong, and you are bold. See, God didn't tell him to be. He just told him to be that, because God knew in Joshua it was there. See, courage, faith, and determination is in you. It's in you. It's there. Only thing you got to do is just operate in it, act upon that, because it's in you. But you know, it took some faith for Abraham to walk out of his well-known place, his well-known place. He's been there for a while, you know, and then all of a sudden God telling him, leave. Leave. Get out of here. And so Abraham did what God told him to do. So he went ahead and he gathered his family and all his stuff, and everything he gathered, he took it with him. He just did what God told him to do. See, that's what God is asking of us. Just do what I tell you. And not only just do what I tell you, he said, trust me in this. See, because it's going to take courage and faith and determination to help you to go into the unknown. I say it's going to take faith, courage, and determination to help you to go into the unknown. See, Abraham didn't know where he was going. He just obeyed God. God said, go. And he packed his stuff and left. He didn't argue. He didn't debate. He didn't say, well, God, I've been here for a long, long time. And I got roots here. And I'm a family here, my friends. I got my business here. And Lord, and you want me to leave all this? See, sometimes we got to leave our familiar place and get away from those familiar landmarks that we so used to seeing. Because God wants to do something different in our lives. But you see, the only way he's going to do different in your life is that you got to let him do it. He's not going to make you do it. You got to allow him and give him permission to do it for you. And not only that, you got to trust him just like Abraham did. I mean, he taking his family. It wasn't just him. He's taking his family. And he's responsible. Whatever happens to his family, it's all on Abraham. So we'll turn that around. It's all on you. It's all on you also. But Abraham trusts God. He trusts God so much that he's willing to lay his life down for this thing. He said, okay, God, I'm going to do it because you said do it. So, God, you said I could be bold, I could be courageous, and I could be strong. And you can be. Because, see, you got to remember, the Father is in you. If you're born again and filled with God's Spirit, and you know Jesus Christ, your Lord and Savior, the Father is in you. Because the Father is in you, you can do that. You can be courageous. You can be faithful. You could be determined because the Father is in you. Just like your desires, when your desires, it's not your desires, it's his desire because the Father is in you and the desires are coming from him, not from you. See? Amen? Amen. So go to Deuteronomy chapter 31. Deuteronomy chapter 31. Hallelujah. And we'll read from verse 1. Everybody there? And Moses went and spake these words unto all Israel. And he said to them, I am 120 years old this day. That's what God promised us, 120 years old. I'm looking forward for that day. Hallelujah. He said, I can no more go out and come in. Also the Lord has said unto me, thou shalt not go over this Jordan. The Lord thy God, he will go over before thee, and he will destroy these nations from before thee, and thou shalt possess them. And Joshua, he shall go over before thee, as the Lord has said. Hallelujah. And the Lord shall do unto them as he did unto Sihon, and to Og, king of the Amorites, and unto the land of them whom he destroyed. And the Lord shall give them, say that with me, and the Lord shall give them, up before your face, that you may do unto them according unto all the commandments which I have commanded you. But verse 6 says, he said, be strong. Be strong. Be strong. See, that's a command. That's a command. Anytime you say be, that's a command. Like when you say be thou, take that mountain, be thou removed, be thou cast into sea, you commanded that mountain to move. So he said, be strong. I command you to be strong and of a good courage. Fear not. Fear not. Nor be afraid of them. For the Lord thy God, he it is that doeth go with thee, and he will not fail thee nor forsake thee. So what God is saying here, he said, I'm not going to leave you. Just do what I tell you. I'm not going to leave you. I'm a man of my word. I keep my word. And not only that I'm not going to leave you, he said, I'm not going to leave you and leave you in that state that you are in and allow stand still and to watch you get beaten up.
That's good. That's good.
Amen. So God is saying, I'm not going to stand here and watch you get beaten up. I will never leave you nor forsake you. I'm here for you. I'm here. Just believe that I'm here. Hallelujah. So praise your name, Lord God. Thank you, Father. But he said, be strong and of a good courage. Fear not, nor be afraid of them, for the Lord thy God, he is that doth go with thee, and he will not fail thee nor forsake thee. And verse 7 says, and I lost my place here. Oh, there it is. And Moses called unto Joshua and said unto him, in the sight of all Israel, here it is again. Be strong. Be strong. Be strong. And of here it is again. And of a what? A good courage. For thou must go with this people unto the land which the Lord has sworn unto their fathers to give them. And thou shalt cause them to inherit it. And verse 8 says, and the Lord, he it is that doeth go before thee. He will be with thee. He will not fail thee, neither forsake thee. Fear not, neither be dismayed. See, God is saying this twice. Anytime God says something twice, it's time for you to take heed. Anytime he says anything twice, it's time for you to take heed to what he said. Anytime you tell your children, I told you not to do it, don't you do that again. I told you not to do it, don't you do that again. Sometimes you might say it three times. What I said to you, don't you do it again. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So he said, be strong. That's a command for you to be strong. Because, see, you can be strong. So like I said, for greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Because you have the greater one in you, and you can do that. In Philippians, it says, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Because Christ gives you the strength to do whatever you need to do. But you got to depend and rely upon his strength and not your strength. And you wonder why things ain't working and you're messing up? Because you trying to do it. Because I can remember I was trying to work the word instead of let the word work for me. And because I didn't let the word work for me, I was frustrated. I was getting frustrated because I was doing it. But then the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me and said, let the word work for you. Don't you try to work. I mean, you know, I could work the word, but, you know, I'm saying I'm trying to do it in my own strength, into my own power, try to make this word work because I want it so bad that I was trying to do it myself and it wasn't working. And he said Ephesians 6, he said, finally, in verse 16, he said, finally, my brother and sister, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. See, not your might. He said, his might. And the only way you can be strong in his might is to be strong in faith. Be strong in courage. Be strong in determination. Be strong in boldness. Be strong because you can be strong. You can handle the situation. Hallelujah. You can handle the situation. I don't care what it is. You can handle the situation. Any kind of demons, any kind of monkey comes your way, you can deal with that. Because why? The greater one is in me than he is in the world. I have boldness, I have courage, and I have determination. I have it. Because God said I have it, I have it. I don't care what nobody say, I have it. Amen. And God told Joshua to be strong and be courageous because you know why? Joshua had to go divide this land, but he had to be strong, and he had to be bold, and he had to be courageous, because some of them people were going to try to take all the land that they can get instead of distributing it out. Are you with me? So if God had told Joshua, because God knew that Joshua had it in him, so he had to have those three things. Because I want this, and I want this, and I want that. No, you can't have that. This is what I'm gonna give you this, and you can have that, and that's it. I got to say something for Pastor Sharp and Lady Gwen. They got to have a piece of this, too. And also you all, you got to have a piece of this, too. Because you know how people are, they want to take everything. Everything. I say you can have two cookies. They want to take half of my cookies. You say you want a couple, but you done took the whole half a bag. Say something for me and somebody else. You know how we are. We take more than what we want. Ooh, Jesus. Take more than we want. You know, because I want this and I want that. Yeah, it's all about wants. That's right. All about wants. Selfish. Thinking nobody but me and mine. That's it. Well, not only me and mine, but I'm thinking about me only. Okay, hallelujah. You know that God already made you a conqueror? Romans 8:37. And not only he made you a conqueror, he already made you a champion. You are a champion. You are a conqueror. Not only just a conqueror, but you're more than a conqueror. See, more than a conqueror, it gives God the glory and the honor. A conqueror, he only takes credit for himself, what I've done, what I have done, what I did, and what I have achieved. That's what a conqueror, but God, the word of God said, you're more than a conqueror through Christ Jesus, because it's through Jesus that make you a conqueror. And not only that, he not only made you a conqueror, you are a success. Whether you believe it or not, you are a success. You may not look like it, you're being a success. You may think that you're failing, but you're not failing. You are a success because God made you a success. God did not create no cowards. And we got a lot of cowards in the body of Christ today. Now, don't throw no stone at me because I ain't call nobody name. Keep your stone to yourself. But you got to say what God says, because that's how God see you. He see you courageous. He see you faithful. He see you determined. And those are three attributes, not only the only ones, but that's what we as a body of Christ, that's what we got to operate in. We got to be courageous. Courageous to stand against the devil and the demons, because Jesus was not fearful. He faced his enemies, and he told his enemies what to do. Leave, get out of here. And they left and they got out. So you can do the same thing too, because for great is he that is in you than he is in the world. So if the greater one is in you, you can do it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Okay, go to Daniel chapter 3. Daniel chapter 3. Hallelujah. The Lord is good, and his mercy endureth forever. The Lord is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Amen. Let me get my iPad here. See, this is my iPad. I got an iPad, but I don't know how to work it. So I went to my pastor and asked him, what can I do? So he gave me the information I need so I can do it. See, I want to say something at this point. You know, that's my pastor. I love him. God put him in my life. And I appreciate him very much. And I know he's a young man. I know I'm an older man. And why can I, as an older man, go and ask my pastor, a younger man? Because, see, that ain't nothing but pride. Who that, I don't mean no harm when I say this, pastor, but who that young buck think he is for me to go to him and ask him some information? It should be the other way around. That's why God told you to ask him, dummy. Go and ask the pastor, because ain't nothing but pride. That's all it is, you know. But I'm glad he's in my life. I'm glad I could go to him and ask him anything, and I know I'm going to get the right answer. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What I say, Daniel chapter 3, right? Daniel chapter 3, let's go verse 15 through 18. You know the story. Nebuchadnezzar had made an image, and he was telling everybody that when you hear the music, the horns, and all these things, you're going to want you to bow down at the image that I have made. But then there was these three Hebrew boys who served God, who loved the Lord, and was not going to turn nothing from him. So they didn't bow down. So here comes the well, I guess you call it the haters they use this day, the word haters. Here they come. I mean, how they knew that they, how come they didn't bow down? But they're looking at everybody else and bow down. How come he said everybody bowed down? Well, what you doing looking at us? What you doing looking at us? How come you not bowing down? And that's what they did to David, huh? He was praying three times to the Lord. And they watching, looking in the window and everything. He's up there praying again. He praying again. He praying to his God again. Well, what you doing? Why are you following David around? Or Daniel, I'm sorry. Why are you following Daniel around looking and see what he's doing? And that's how a lot of us in the body of Christ is. We trying to see if anybody else is doing what God said to do. But what are you doing? He said, see, if you in the faith, don't worry about what everybody else is in the faith. You make sure that you walk in the right way. And leave everybody else alone. See, what they need some deliverance. They need to get saved. That's what it really is. They need to really, really, truly get saved. Yeah, that's what it is. So anyway, we'll go down to verse 15. And we'll read to verse 18. I know I said it, but you know what? I'm going to read it anyway. Now, if you be read that at what time you hear the sound of the cornet, flute, the harp, the sackbut, psaltery, dulcimer, and all kinds of music, you fall down and worship the image. Then let's go down to the bottom down here. It says, and who is this God that shall deliver you out of my hands? Who is this God? Who is he that shall deliver you out of my hands? Like he, Mr. Big Stuff, huh? Who do you think you are? Y'all remember that song, huh? So I'm telling my age now. You mean, oh, Pastor, oh, man. Who don't live that long, Pastor? Yeah, Mr. Big Stuff. And then verse 17, if it be so, our God whom we serve shall able to deliver us from the burning fire furnace. And the word able there is to mean that God is qualified to do it. But you got to know that God is qualified to do that for you. So do you believe that? That he is able? We always say, well, the Lord is able. Yeah, he's able. But what about you? Are you able to trust him? Are you able to rely upon him? Are you able to depend upon him? Are you able to trust him? Yeah, the Lord is able. Y'all heard him say it, huh? The Lord is able. Then ask the question, are you able? They don't know what to say after then. But you got to know that God is able. So Daniel says, verse 17, if it be so, our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fire furnace, and he will deliver us out of thy hand, O King. See, it took some courage to talk to the king like that. It took some courage, some confidence to talk to the man like this, because, you know, they were bold. Because they were bold, and they knew that God was going to deliver them. Do you have the assurance that God will deliver you? We talk it, but do you really believe that he will deliver you out of this? Yes. Do you really believe that God and I are the majority in this situation? See? Are you sure about that? Are you fully persuaded, like Abraham? He was fully persuaded that God was going to do what he said he was going to do. But are you persuaded? Hallelujah. But verse 18 says, but if not, so what if he don't do it? I don't care if he ever does it for me. But I know one thing, I'm not going to give in. I'm not going to bow. See, if there's been a lot of us face this situation, we would have tapped out. What I mean by tapped out, you know how they get you in a hole and try to get you to submit? You know, like you go break your arm or tear your shoulder apart, separate your shoulder, and they make you, they force you to tap out. And see, that's what we do when the pressure come up on us. You know, we want to tap out instead of trusting God. We want to tap out. But why are you tapping out? For great is he that's in you than he is in the world. No weapon that is formed against me shall prosper. No weapon shall prosper against. If it does form, it's not going to be a success. Hallelujah. It's not going to be a success. But you got to know that. No weapons formed against you shall prosper. Because God said no weapon. I don't care what it is. It's not going to prosper against you. So stand up in courage. Stand up in faith. And be determined to fight this fight as a good soldier. Endure this hardship. Because you can endure this hardship. You can do that. Because you courage, you faithful, and you determined. See, we get to the courage part and the faithful part, but when it comes down to the determination, that we find that we wing off right there. Because it's too much work. But you got to work it. You got to work it. That's the only way it's going to do it. You got to work the courage and you got to work the faith. And just like some of us, when we was pursuing our mates, we did everything we could do possible to pursue her or him. It got quiet on that one. But you know how determined you was. You look good. You smell good. You know, you make sure you took a shower and a bath and everything. You had all your perfume all on you. You poured just about the whole bottle on you. And he's in the bathroom. He's in there. Yeah, I'm ready now. I'm going to pursue now. Hallelujah. I mean, is it true? That's what you did. I've done it, so don't look at me like that. I ain't here by myself. You know you did it. And some of you are still doing it. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So we see here that they said, verse 18, but if not, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. See, you got to be like that. Got to be determined to say, I'm not going to turn my back on God no matter what. The devil may park on your shoulder and say, that stuff ain't working. You've been paying tithes for 25 years and you ain't received your harvest yet. That stuff don't work. You may just leave it alone. Because I got something for you. I can help you out. And it won't take that long either. Now, I got a kilo of grass over here, and you can make a lot of money in 1 week. Wow. Yeah, go ahead and sell this cocaine. It's quick money. It's quick money. But you got to pay for that. If you get caught, guess what? You're going to jail. And we'll be coming, passing some pamphlets so you can read to you. Yeah. And say, devil, I'm not going to tap out. I'm not going to give up. I'm going to continue on paying my tithes. I'm going to continue giving my offering. I'm going to continue going to church. I'm not going to stop praying. I'm not going to stop interceding. I'm not going to stop. So, devil, In the name of Jesus, I command you to shut up right now. Because you are a stranger, and the voice of a stranger I do not hear. Because you are a stranger, I don't recognize your voice. But you still got to be courage. You still got to be faithful. And you still got to be determined. There's been times I didn't want to come to church. I didn't want to come to Bible study. Because my body, I didn't feel well. But you know what? That's the time to go. I told my body, we going to church tonight. I said, body, we are going to church tonight. See, you are in control. Not your body. You are in control. That's why God sent you here to live in his body so you can run the body. They went on somebody's head, huh? Just went, phew. But that's the truth, right? God sent, because you are a spirit. You live in a physical body. It's because of you, this body is functioning the way it is. Because you are in this body. And God made it just for you. God made this house just for you. And you tell this house what to do. What it's going to be like. What's going to happen. What ain't going to happen. But you got to be courage enough to do that. You got to be bold enough to say to your body, you know, yeah, you talk to, yeah, I talk to my body. You need to talk to your body. That's why some of you are in trouble because you're not talking to your body. You just go ahead and just do whatever it wants to do and you give into it. And then you wonder why what things they have because you're not in control. Your body's in control. Yeah, I'm talking to you too out there. Yeah, I'm talking to you too. Yes, I am. You too. You're allowing your body to do whatever it wants to do. When you have the power and authority to control that body, you dominate that body. Don't let the body dominate you and telling you what to do. And you wonder why things ain't going your way, why there's a chaos in your life, because you're letting the wrong fella run. The wrong fella is running the show. Instead of letting God run the show. But you are to run the show. You tell your body what to do. Not your body telling you what to do. No, I'm not going to eat that cherry pie today. I'm not going to have that cherry pie today and that vanilla ice cream. Ooh, and the Haagen-Dazs. Ooh. Yeah, it's calling your name. Help me, help me, help me, eat me, eat me. You know you want to eat me. Help me, help me, help me, help me, help all of me. And it's time for you to run away from that thing. Get away from it because it's a trap. It's a trap. It's setting you up for the fall. Hallelujah. Oh, Jesus, let me get back to my lesson. Go to 1 Samuel chapter 17. 1 Samuel 17. Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. Just take one, just a little bite, just a taste of me. That's all I'm asking, just a little taste. And that's all it takes, just that taste. He said, well, I just may just go ahead and eat the whole thing now since I done started. And then after a while, after you get through eating, then you want to repent. Lord, forgive me. Forgive me, God, if I gave into that temptation. But Lord, it was looking so good. I got tasted, my mouth was watering, and oh, my taste bud was just jumping, and I had to have it. Now you want to repent and ask God to forgive you now. Yeah. Yeah. See, it's okay for the temptation to come, but it's what you do with the temptation. Because you are courageous, you can overcome that temptation. I couldn't help myself. No, you didn't want to help yourself. And that's all I'm going to say about that one. That's all I'm going to say. I think everybody got the message when I said that one. Yeah. So I'm going to get in my lane now. I don't want to get out of my lane. I'm going to stay in my lane right here. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 32 through verse 45. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Are we having fun?
Yes,
are we having fun? Amen. Hallelujah. 1 Samuel chapter 17, verse 32 to 45. Let's read verse 31. And when the words were heard which David spake, they rehearsed them before Saul. And he sent for him. And David said to Saul, let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine. And Saul said to David, thou art not able. Hear that word able again. Telling David, you're not qualified. See, some of you are listening to the devil telling you that you're not qualified. But you are qualified. They're saying you're not qualified in this position because you don't have your PhD and HDD and WDDs and all this stuff. And that's what they tell you, you know, because you're not qualified. You don't have the stuff. Yes, I do. I got the stuff. You have the stuff, and you are qualified. So don't let the devil talk you out of it. Where was I? Okay. 33. And Saul said to David, thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he is a man of war from his youth. And David said unto Saul, thy servant kept his father's sheep. And there came a lion and a bear and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went after him and smote him and delivered it out of his mouth. See, that's what you need to do. When the enemy trying to snatch something from you and take from you, you run to that devil. I have learned how to do that. Run to the devil. Don't flee from the devil. When sickness attack your body, run to it. Attack it. Okay. And out of the paw of the bear, and he would deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said to David, go, and the Lord be with you. In other words, I'll be back here in the tent. I'm going to be back here in the tent praying for you. You go ahead in the name of the Lord, but I'm going to be in my tent, and I'm going to be here praying for you. Because he didn't expect David to come back. And it's sad to say, a lot of people, your brothers and sisters in the church, not expecting for you to succeed. In anything you do, they think that you're going to fail. They're going to watch you. They did this to Faith Christian Center Church. They thought it was going to be a flunk. They set a date on it. That it ain't going to last long. And it's been here, what, 15 years now? 15 long years and still going strong. And I thank God that I'm a part of this myself, that I'm part of it. You know, I'm on the playing field too. I'm not on the sideline. I'm on the field too. Hallelujah. So God said, he said, and go, and the Lord be with thee. So he didn't think that they was going to succeed, they was going to be a prosper or anything. They was going to be up to nothing. And try to talk him out of his victory. Did you hear me? He was trying to talk David out of his victory. And that's what's happening to a lot of you, is that you're allowing the devil to talk you out of your victory. The devil not talking me out of my victory. He not taking my victory from me. He not taking my victory from me. And don't let the devil take your victory. See, because you are courage. You are courageous. You are faithful. And you are determined. But see, that last one, that's what you got to be determined. to pursue it. You got to be determined to not to give up. You got to be determined to not to tap out. I don't care how much the pressure the devil put on you. See, it's time for you to put pressure on him. When Jesus was in the wilderness, and the devil was tempting him and trying to get him to do all this thing, Jesus put pressure on the devil. It is written. It is written. It is written. And that's what you got to do. It is written, devil. It is written. It is written, devil. It is written. Put the pressure on him. And stop letting him put the pressure on you. Hallelujah. Praise your name, Lord. Thank you, Father. Ooh, Jesus, hallelujah. Let's go to Mark chapter 5. Is this helping anyone? Because I know it helped me and it is helping me. Hallelujah. I love the word of God. I mean, I love the word, how it does, you know, how God deliver you, how he gets you out of positions and situations. I mean, God just good. He just good. And faithful and just. Yes, he is. And he's mighty. He's all that. But we got to know that he is that. Hallelujah. What I say now, Mark chapter 5, verse 25. And a certain woman which had an issue of blood 12 years and had suffered many things of many physicians, and had spent all that she had and was nothing better but what? Grew worse. When she had heard the word, because Jesus was the word. So when she heard the word, it brought some courage, courageousness in her. It built her faith up, and she was determined to do something. We'll get there. I'm getting ahead a bit myself. For she said. And that's what you got to do. You got to say it. You ain't going to have it unless you say it. Hallelujah. Okay, for she said, if I may touch but his clothes, I shall be made whole. See, not only did she touch his clothes, no, I got it that she touched him. She touched him. Even though I know it said the clothes, but this is what I got out of it, she touched him. Because it was part of him. Just like my clothes is part of me. So when you touch my clothes, you're touching me also, because it's part of me. It's not me, but it's part of me. All right. And verse 29, and straightway the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of that plague. And Jesus, meeting anointing himself, that virgin had gone out of him, turned him about in the press and said, who touched my clothes? Who touched my clothes? That's me going off over here. That's my reminder. Hallelujah. But anyway, let me finish this here. But the woman, fearing and trembling, knowing what was done in her, came and fell down before him and told him all the truth. See, that's what you got to do. You got to come with Jesus with all the truth and be honest with him. You cannot lie to him. You can't lie, so he's not just forget it. But you got to come to him truthfully. And she did. She said, Jesus, I've been like this condition for 12 years. I done went to every specialist. I done went to every doctor that I could go to, and nothing but gratitude. I'm broke. I don't have no money. But then when I heard about you, hallelujah, my courageness and my faithfulness and my determination. See, we see faith, we see courage, faith, and determination right here. We see all three of them. All at one time. So she said, Jesus, that's what happened. But then when I heard about you and how you was doing those marvelous works and how you were healing people and doing things, I said within myself that, but if I get to you, I know it's going to be all right. And so since I came here and I got here, everything is all right. Amen. Well, I got to stop because I am out of time.